just the biggest race of Fabio Quartararo's life coming up in about, 30 minutes' time. The biggest day of his life. The first match point at the Misano World Circuit, Marco Simoncelli starts from his worst ever qualifying in the MotoGP World Championship. 15th place then for Fabio.
Is this the day of destiny for Quartararo?
You know, I was waiting for so long to first of all see the bike with my number on the wheel, and yeah, it was super special and was quite nervous because, you know, it was taking the place of Valentino. It was pretty stressful, more looking at all the people around, you know, like the fans, the media, the pressure that it have to, you know, being on the bike of Valentino. To be honest, I was super stressed because, you know, it was the first one. First race as Yamaha factory. When we are on the bike, we are just not riding. We need to think about the maps, about the tires. And that race I was riding like it was my first time.
The green flag waves. 2021 is underway. Quartararo up the inside of Jorge Martin. Here he comes.
He's
that was
it.
Beautifully done. He's done it on the straight. It will be the move into turn one that he needed. Good move that by Vinales. What a ride though by this young man.
When your teammate win the race and you finish five, obviously something was wrong, no?
I get very surprised about the top spot. I don't lose. I lose a little bit, but
the
way of we
acted
last corner was fantastic.
That day when Maverick won, I will not say it was tough, but was there is another race next week. It's my turn.
After GP1, he analyzed how Maverick won the GP.
You know, during Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, we stayed in the hotel, and I was thinking only about one thing, about where I should change for next week. I was on race mode already from Monday.
The race two, he was so determined and so confident, like he will make something great.
It's the Tissot Grand Prix of Doha. Round two. Quartararo just picks him straight back up. Lovely, yeah. Block pass. Great. Look at that. That's not... Here he comes now, the race winner tonight, no questions about it. A stunner from Fabio Quartararo to win.
I think for me the best race of the season was in Qatar. To win the second one was something super special. To just say we are here.
Ha sido muy constante el brazo. Sí. Es que no arpapé, que me echó una tendinitis en la otra carrera. Ya. Y ahora me salió.
You know, having already a first operation on my arm, I thought was going to be okay. I expect that to be the just, you know, a normal pain. Sometimes I have pain on the left, but it's not arm pump. I didn't expect to have some difficulties next.
Normally, when Fabio lose position during last year, was difficult to come back. And Qatar 2, he was 10th, and he win the race. And after this one, I say, oh, now we can be good this season.
Usually in Qatar, we always perform well. When we came to Portugal, where last year we suffered, we struggled, we were waiting this GP as a really banco prova, bench test.
25 laps of the famous Algarve International Circuit in pole position yesterday for flying Frenchman Fabio Quartararo. Can Yamaha start a MotoGP season with three wins in a row? Quartararo moves up to third. Oh, that's beautifully done. Here he goes. He's got the move done. He's got the inside line. Outstanding from the Yamaha man.
¿Dónde vas? Con 61 puntos.
Tengo más que el año pasado ya.
Enhorabuena, tío.
Gracias.
Buena carrera, ¿eh?
¿Cómo estás?
Bien, bien, bien. ¿Sí? Habéis abusado de mí, ¿eh? No, pero buena carrera, tío.
When I won in Portimao, that in 2020 was the worst track for us, and I won there with an amazing pace. I say, look, now this is my year.
In Jerez, we were close to win the third race in a row.
Sunny Spain as we kick off for round four. He's the world championship leader, back-to-back wins in Doha and in Portimao for Fabio Quartararo. He's a big pre-race favourite. Can Yamaha continue their incredible start?
And again, another problem just stopped us when basically the race was already in the pocket.
I was fifth and overtake one every lap and pull away, and just had no power after a few laps, and was something that I didn't expect, because all the weekend was okay, and on the race I just had that problem.
Is it arm pump? Right arm. Is it arm pump? What? Because he's holding his arm in a funny way.
He was,
man.
Wasn't he? Yeah.
He's in serious pain. I think it's a physical issue.
I was already quite sad about the result, and I had headaches from the people telling me, go there. So then I say, look, I go in the motorhome, I don't want to see nobody, and I will think with my people what we need to do.
I said, okay, take one day to decide, it's your decision, don't feel any kind of pressure from anybody.
So we directly take a flight to Marseille to get the surgery, and was difficult because he was so disappointed, but we go in Marseille and we enjoy. We visit a little bit the city before, and we try to think about, okay, it will be much better in the next race.
Was, I think, the toughest moment of this year. Many people say it's okay, you win the championship, but no, it's a race where I wanted to win there. A tough moment, but also a moment where I say, I will be back stronger.
We were lucky, the surgery went really well. So yeah, in Le Mans, he was okay to do his best.
But you can move your hand on.
Yeah, I can. I can, just sometimes it's electricity when I move.
Oh, yeah?
Because I have the stitches inside, you know?
Ah, oh, but it's okay.
And yeah, this race was really important because it was mixed condition, like flag to flag. Was the first race flag to flag for him.
In the dry condition, when it starts to rain, I'm not so great. And in Le Mans, I say, look, in the wet, I'm even worse. So if I need to make the gap with the others, is when it starts to rain with the slicks. And I think the podium that we had in Le Mans was just about this one lap and a half where I pushed like hell.
And he did really well, more than I think everybody expect.
Yeah. Welcome back MotoGP to magnificent Mugello. 23 laps of the Italian Grand Prix. Pole for World Championship leader Fabio Quartararo.
I asked the whole show device, front device from Qatar. We pushed the Japanese quite hard for it, and it arrived in the best moment. For me, Mugello and Barcelona was a track where we really need to have it.
And since we introduced the front start device in Mugello, we made a big step.
We managed to get really great starts and was a really good help for us. You know, it was a track where was supposed to be Ducati land, and I make pole position and win. So it's just the moment where you say, okay, we are super strong.
So when we won there, I really start thinking that we could really achieve the goal.
The Monster Energy Grand Prix of Catalunya. Our eyes to the center of the picture and the lights are on. Quartararo has bolted down towards turn one, but here comes Miller again. He's catching back up.
Catalunya, to be honest, I take it more like a laugh. Because, you know, for me there we could fight for the win, for sure, and for the second position, sure. I finished third.
He's going to try, bow, he's almost he lost the front there, and he's shaking his head. It's going wrong for the World Championship leader. He might just lose another place here to Jack Miller as well as he rejoins the circuit. This was earlier on. See, a bit uncomfortable. He's got his leathers open there. What's going on? You can see his necklace and his bare chest. Strange in the extreme. Will there be some kind of penalty?
Then some people got to complain in the race direction when I lose the... Well, because my leather were open, so I had 3 seconds more penalty. Because I could be like super angry, and I take it like a laugh, say, this will not stop me.
This year, we try to change the things, you know, in funny way.
Right now, I try to get angry on my helmet with the visor closed, and as soon as I open the helmet, I try to be as calm as possible from the outside.
He really impressed us in many different ways. He was always able to find a positive thing.
He has much more confidence in himself, and he is not angry for small reason like before. The road was difficult, but finally it was great. And sometimes when it's bad situation, we think about this, and I tell him, hey, remember 3 years ago or 4 years ago? So, and I always tell him it was funny. We enjoy at this moment, and you were P28, and we were laughing and everything. So now you are first in MotoGP, enjoy.
We saw him growing up, also his self-belief growing up.
In 2020, we had some tough moments, but I wanted always to, you know, to show the people I was fast, but then I realized I don't need to show nobody what I need to do. I know my potential, I know what is my goal, and I don't care about
what I need to show.
They never put pressure on him, never. So this is, I think, a reason also why Fabio is fast this season.
He's enjoying what he's doing, having fun during the race weekend.
No te he visto, tío, pero venían rápido.
Se acaban en la tele todo el rato.
He understood somehow how to use the strong point of this bike and somehow how to compensate the weak points. And this let him be consistent.
Sta andando bene la moto, eh?
Sì, in pista vedo che è curva piccola e...
Mentre in linea accelerazione la Yamaha sarà meglio per la Ducati.
He never got the panic, and he really took the most of it, each race.
This aspect actually has been the main point this season, because we said many times that the most important thing is not be super good in the good days, but is important be not too bad in a bad day, no?
Silverstone is the race where is the first time of my life, of my career, that before the race I knew I was going to win, and it was a strange feeling. I never felt nervous, I always felt good.
It was waiting that track, because in 2019 he crashed, and it was the first time I was so direct and strong with him. He remembered this kind of approach, and then when he arrived there he was convinced not to be strong enough to fight for the victory, and then he did it.
A good acceleration away from everybody.
I was in a fight with Mia, and I'm like, once everything calmed down, I looked, and I'm like, okay, that's the first position we came out on the Formula One track.
Yes.
And you was fucking nearly turning into the first corner.
Yes. I say,
when did he go so far in front? How did he was like one lap and he was gone.
And was funny because with my manager that weekend, he saw that I was super focused and I wanted to win. And he just told me, look, sometimes, because we always finish in front and gain points in the championship, say, look, maybe sometimes we're gonna lose points with the opponent, so be calm and say, yeah, yeah. And then we take 20 points in the championship, so it was a big, big achievement in Silverstone.
Good afternoon and welcome to Misano World Circuit, Marco Simoncelli.
Bagnaia starts from pole position,
and Fabio Quartararo, with five races to go, holds a 53-point lead.
Misano is a different story because it's a kind of track where Pecco is very strong. This is a bit the story of this season. One bike is strong in one circuit. If it's the case of Ducati, there are a lot of Ducati on the grid. So you have to fight with four or five riders.
It was difficult for me to fight with them because normally we always have some positive and negative. And at that moment, I don't see the negative. So I just say to the team, look, right now I can't do nothing because they are stronger than us in every things.
Lights out!
the lead into turn one. Jack Miller, the inside of Fabio Quartararo. Now Quartararo is going to lose another place. Here comes Quartararo then. What a battle this is for third. That was beautifully done by Fabio Quartararo.
I said, look, what should I do? Make a gap with Jack and try to finish on second, or give my best and try for the win? I say, I'm going for the win. And I pushed like hell to win. And I had many moments where I think I was going to be on the ground. And it's a race where I really enjoy. I think it's one of the most, even if I finish second. But to push myself to the limit on that situation that we were with many points in the championship leading, I was proud of myself because it was tough.
Okay. 2-5 l'ultimo giro, infatti lui stava arrivando su con un matto.
Sì,
ma...
L'ultima parte te facevi paura.
Ma quando hai fatto con il tiro off, hai perso un po' di tempo.
Non riuscivo a toglierlo, non vedevo più, dovevo togliere per forza.
Was just to show our speed and my confidence. Show to myself more than to the others, because I say, look, many people say, you start to have the pressure of the championship. I say, no. And I think not many people believed in what I said. And I think there is like, yeah, he really don't have the pressure of the championship, because I gave everything and I was super proud of myself on that race. In Austin, I had a lot of pressure. I remember I said to Tom that I was more nervous than normal. I had my manager on the phone. So was a moment where we really need to think about the championship. And I was nervous, and I think it's a normal process. You know, if you have no stress and no pressure, it's because you don't care. And when you care a lot, you have these kind of things, and that moment were tough.
I see a different Fabio. He was already really stressed. The last two races, Austin and Misano, was the worst, because I never saw him like this since 15. When he have a lot of pressure on himself, he just have to look on the right and I'm here. So, and I'm always making stupid joke or something, so he's already, just he have to look at me, and if I think that's helped him a lot.
To have your best friend in that kind of moments is always nice, and with a normal person that you can't really talk with confidence is different. To having him, he knows how to take me out some stress more than pressure.
Before the race also, I'm the last to leave, so I always tell him a small word like enjoy, or, and at the end I was telling him go with your head. Just this. The race is long, calm, don't make stupid things. And this is important for him. Small gest, small word, he don't need a lot.
We're back in Austin after a 30-month absent. Eyes to the lights. Who's going to be last on the brakes into the first corner? Oh, that was tight. Marc Marquez wins in Austin. Fabio Quartararo, a brilliant second place.
It was like a victory. I remember arriving to the Parc Fermé, revving the bike because I was super happy. When you came from a lot of pressure on the grid, to having a good result is like all the rest. You are super happy, and also was the moment to stop Pecco a little bit, because he win in Aragon, he win in Misano, so now you finish behind. And was a moment to say, okay, I have the pressure, but I finish in front of you also. For the Ducati, to see that I finish in front of them was, you know, something that we say, okay, it's, this year is for us and not for you, sorry. And was a moment where we say, okay, now it's just about being intelligent. Even if the results are not really here, we will fight for the championship. And it's what happened.
That before to start the race, this was shit.